You'll get player back ready to serve, partners at the net, and we got two players in serve receive. So in this example, the server is serving into the wind. But serving in the wind, the safest serve is to serve the ball directly into the wind. If you serve it from up here, and you serve cross court, the wind's gonna push it. You serve it from this side, you serve it cross court, the wind's gonna push it this way. In this example, the wind is blowing cross court. It's better to serve the ball from here towards the middle, or maybe even down the line, because the ball is gonna be pushed across court. Another strategy would be to serve the ball from here, this direction, cross court into the wind, and that could keep the ball in the court. Serve cross court, and it'll drop down to the middle of the court. A risky serve would be to serve the ball from this side of the court, straight down the line. If you do that, the wind's blowing cross court, the wind's going to push it out of bounds. Now, when the wind is blowing the other direction cross court, this is the safer serve, the serve from this side of the court, serve to the middle, serve more a little bit down the line or to the middle of the court. Or serving from the middle, you could serve more to the middle. Serve from here, serve to this player, and that'll keep the ball in the court. If you're going to serve from this side, be sure to serve cross court into the wind. If you serve down the line, the wind will push it out. In this example, the wind is at the server's back, so the server could serve from anywhere along the end line. It's usually tougher to serve short when the wind is at your back. So usually the strategy is to serve a ball hard and deep with the wind. Learning to serve with the wind at your back isn't nearly as important as learning to serve when you're serving into the wind. A lot of people don't like it when it's windy. Most don't like the wind, and they don't know how to use it. Just like everything else, using the wind is a skill. To be good in the wind, you have to have a plan for how you're going to use the wind, and you're going to have to be able to recognize these situations. Here are some of the things you need to know when it comes to playing in the wind. When serving into the wind, be sure and put topspin on the ball so the wind will push the ball down. When serving a floater into the wind, the ball could be pushed up or down or side to side. Therefore, it could be tougher to control floaters, and it could be tougher to keep them in the court. It's usually tougher to pass a ball that's served into the wind. Passing a ball that has been served into the wind is much tougher to pass than a ball that is served with wind. Have you ever missed a serve and blamed it on the wind? This is because you didn't know how to use the wind. With practice, you can become better at using the wind to your advantage. You are going to become better at predicting what the wind is going to do to the ball. Most people don't know how to use the wind to their advantage. This is a big problem. Most prefer to serve with the wind at their back and really don't like serving into the wind. But actually, it can be a lot easier to serve into the wind. If you understand the wind and understand how to use the wind, then you can use the wind to help control the ball. Often players struggle serving the ball over the net when they're serving into the wind because the wind pushes the ball down. The key here is to be able to recognize the situation. Here are some things to think about. When serving into the wind, serve the ball harder, higher, and deeper. If the wind is blowing cross court, then serve it cross court into the wind. If you try serving with the crosswind instead of against it, the ball could be pushed out of bounds. This is why serving the ball down the line in a crosswind is risky. Here are a couple tips for hitting into the wind. Okay, for when attacking at the net, hitting at the net, hitting into the wind, you want to hit the ball harder and deeper. If you hit the ball high, hard, and deep, the ball will very likely drop in and it'll be harder to pass. It's very tough to hit this ball out of bounds into the wind. Also, hitting short into the wind is a risky shot. There's a very good chance the ball will be pushed down and won't cross the net. I personally like to play in the wind because I know how to serve and hit when it's windy. It's also tougher to pass when it's windy. But if you're familiar with the wind and you know how to use it and you know what the wind does to the ball, then you're not going to have as much trouble passing as most everybody else is. For passing, it's important to learn the footwork for moving back deep to pass a deep ball. This will make passing a lot easier. When you become good at moving deep to pass a deep serve, it'll be a lot easier to pass in the wind. Now, if you're interested in more tips on how you can use the wind to get an advantage, watch my video on anticipation. The link to watch it is in the description below and also in the cards in this video. If you're struggling when it's windy and you have a question about playing in the wind, please comment below with a follow-up question. If you like this video, please let me know by liking it below. Subscribe and share it with your volleyball friends. And comment below with the word helpful if you found this video has helped.